Hello, welcome to ISTQB Foundation Level Syllabus, and today we are going to see how an individual can contribute to the success of the review process. So even though the organization will provide you everything, but at the end it again comes to the individual how they will make the review process successful. So let's see all those factors one by one. So the first factor is that right people. Choosing right people or making review done by right people is very, very important, because if right people, in the sense, they should have expertise in that particular module, or they should have worked on that particular module for a long time, so that they will have a great understanding about that module. They will know how user is going to that particular module, and depending upon that, they will do the review process. Next is the tester. So tester's participation in a review is very, very important, because the tester will have a different view of point for that particular implementation than the developer. So if there is a difference of opinion or there is different view of points, then it is always good in order to discuss that and go to the or select the best one out of it. So testers' involvement is also very, very important. Next comes is the time. So even though the organization has given you lots of time, but if you are not using those time, then it is also going to be an ineffective review. So if the time is given, we should spend more time with the work product, so that we will have a great understanding about that work product. We will be experienced, our understanding will increase, and by doing that, we can find more number of defects also. And then small chunk is also one of the success factors. So even though the big amount of data is given to you for review, if your approach is like checking the review or checking the work product piece by piece, in that way it will be more effective, and you can find more defects instead of reviewing the whole document at once. So just go small chunks, and then you will find more defects, and it will be more effective. Last one is the communication, maybe the second last one. So the communication also plays a great role. If you have found all the defects, but if you are not able to communicate them properly, in that case, that will not be addressed also. So the communication is also very, very important, and at the proper time you have to communicate. You should not wait for a longer duration. So once you find the defect, just make a report and communicate with the people who are responsible for that. So that way it will be more effective. And last one is the review meeting. So in the meeting, the individual should participate. They should provide their viewpoint, so that it will be discussed in the review meeting and a common consensus will be made between the different viewpoints. So the review meeting is also very, very important here. So these were the factors which are quite important to make the review process successful from the individual point of view. Right people, tester, time, small chunk, communication, and meeting. So that is it from my side regarding this particular topic. I will see you in my next topic. Until then, happy testing.